Hello everyone, in this tutorial, we're gonna see how to use Photoshop to create a design like this that is similar to the famous clothing brand company Rhude. But before we're gonna do that, make sure to subscribe and comment and leave a like. Alright, so let's get to it. Alright, so let's jump to Photoshop and let's go to File, New, and let's create a new document using 3500 for the width and 4000 in the height, and I will change the resolution to 300 and I will keep the color mode set to RGB, but of course if you want to change it to Simweka you can do that and I will press OK. Alright, next I will create a solid color, so let's go to Adjustment and choose Solid Color. And let's actually make this a little bit bright in the brightness. Let's put like 10 and I will press OK. And let's delete this background and the layer mask of the solid color. And let's call this BG for background. And as you can see, we have a ghost canvas. So let's right click on the background of Photoshop and choose custom for this light gray. And I think now we have a really good canvas in here that we can see. Alright, now let's jump to our file, and as you can see I already have the wolf in here from Darren Welsh, but I already cut it as a PNG for us not to waste a lot of time cutting it. And also we're gonna use this Millhouse font, so in case you don't know how to install the font, you can just double click on the font and press install in here and this will install it. And also we're gonna use this dust texture as a PNG. I will make sure to put this in the link where you can download this. Alright, so let's open the wolf image that we'll be using, the PNG, and I will make it smaller, somewhere around, that's right here. Alright, and I will one click on this check mark. Now we'll right click and rasterize this because I don't want it to be in a smart object, and let's rename it to wolf. Alright, so the only thing that I want to apply for this image is a gradient map and maybe a level adjustment. So let's start with a gradient map. Let's choose gradient map from the adjustment and let's clip it to the wolf layer, and then I will open this gradient map. And I will change the black color stop that is for the shadows and the white is for the highlights. So I will double click on this color stop to open the color picker, and I want to change the shadows to like something vintage, like a purple, maybe not that saturated, so let's keep it just right here and I will press OK. And maybe I will move the location to like 7%, and then I will add another color stop in here, and this time I will go for something like green and maybe warmer. Just give it that retro look. Yeah, something like that. I think it will work. And I will press OK. And let's add another color stop, and this time let's go for something even warmer, maybe this orangey color, like a creamy color actually. Yeah, something like that. I think it will look really nice. I like this, and I will press OK. And for this you can just experiment with this, you can just change the colors until you find something that you are happy with. For example, this green, I think I will change it to make it look a little bit stronger, something like that, and I will press OK. And then for the last color stop that I want to add is a yellowish color. Yeah, to add a little bit of highlights, and I will press OK and OK. And I think it looks decent for a vintage look. Alright, I like this. Now we'll go back to adjustment and choose levels, and I will clip it to the wolf. And for this I will just make it a little bit faded using this black slider. Just put it a little bit to like 26%, maybe even less, like 20 or 18. And maybe I will drop down the opacity for like 70%. Alright, so that's what we are going to do for this wolf image. Now it's time for us to type the font. So let's go to the type tool and I will one click. And as you can see, I already have the Mailhouse regular in here selected. So I will type Rhude. And then I will make it smaller, somewhere in here. Also, I want it to be snapped from the edge of these rocks, both of them. So let's make it snap with the other one. And then I will press shift for me to make the font bigger, only from the height. I know this won't be in a proportion way, but it's okay for the font. I mean, for this font especially, it doesn't look really bad while you do that. So I think we can get away with it, something like this. I think it looks okay. And I will one click on this check mark. And then I will take this font and put it under the wolf layer. And I will drag it down a little bit, because I want the head of the wolf to be just right here. Yeah, something like that. I think it looks really nice. Also, I want to add a little bit of text in here, but we can do this later. Next, I want to center this, so I will select the font layer and I will press Ctrl Command and select the wolf, and I will take this and center it. That's right here. Alright, so we are done with the wolf. Now it's time for us to add a little bit of layer size to the text. So let's select the font layer. And let's go to this FX icon and choose blending options. And the first style that we are going to add is a bevel and emboss, but let me reset it to default first. So for the style, I will keep it to inner bevel and the technique to smooth. But for the depth, I will put it all the way up to 1000. And for the direction, I will keep it to up. But for the size, I will change it to 15%, just to give this really nice a 3D look. And of course you can experiment with this, it depends on the resolution of your file. Alright, so for the soften I would keep it to 0, and let's go to the shading. So for the shading I will keep everything in here set to default, but again feel free to change things. And for the gloss contour I will actually change it to this ring one in here. Alright, now for the highlights and the shadow, again I will keep them to default screen with multiply 50-50, and that's what all we're gonna do for the bevel and emboss. And then let's go to gradient overlay to add that vintage gradient. And as you can see, I already have in here two gradients that I want to use. It's either this one or this one. So I will make sure to upload this gradient, both of them, for you if you want to use the same. But basically you can just play with the colors in here. I mean, I saved them because I don't want to choose random colors again. I think this one it looks really nice, and also this one. So let's go for with the first one and press OK, and that will be all. So I'm gonna press OK again, and as you can see we have a really nice retro colors with the font. Alright, now I want to add a little bit of shadow for the wolf in here. So to do that, we're gonna select the wolf layer, and then I will go to this FX icon and choose blending options. And I will go to drop shadow, and I will keep everything in here set to multiply. Maybe the opacity I will put it, yeah, let's keep it actually 70%. And let me put back the size to like 30. pixels. And of course you can move it with your cursor, yeah, something like that. I think I'm happy with that, and I will press OK. Now we don't want the shadow to be applied on everything in here, and for us to avoid that, you can just right click on this FX icon that we have and then choose create layer, and this will show up. Just press OK and this will create a layer using the same drop shadow that we added for the wolf layer. So select the drop shadow layer and then we're gonna apply a layer mask, and then we're gonna press B for the brushes and using black as a foreground color. While we are selecting the layer mask, we can just delete all these parts that we don't want, and if you want to keep some of them like this in here, you can, but for me I will delete all of this. I will just keep the shadows from the font in there. Alright, I think it looks really nice. Now I also want to fade this a little bit, so to do that we're gonna select the wolf layer and add another layer mask for the wolf, and then this time we're gonna use a gradient. So I'm gonna press G on my keyboard and I will change the gradient to this color to transparent in the basic folder, and using black as my foreground color, I can just delete a little bit using the gradient to make it fade with the background. Alright, I think we are looking good. Now I want to add a little bit of a text in here, so I will go back and select the text tool. And for this one, actually I'm gonna change it to Roboto, and I will one click and I will make a quote just like that. Let me actually change the color of the font to white first. Alright, let me open a quote. Yeah, well, we have it clipped with the wolf, that's why. So let me unclip this and let's start over. Let's put a quote and then put howling for you, end of the quote, and then I'm gonna press Ctrl Command T and I will make this smaller and I will put it just right here. Alright, I think it looks really nice. Now it's time for us to add the texture. So let's go to the folder and let's drag this texture and open it in here. And again, I'm gonna press shift to resize this without keeping the proportion of the texture. Yeah, somewhere just right here. Alright, and I will one click on this check mark. And then we will change the blending mode to color dodge. And there we go, we have a really nice texture on top of everything. And for you to have the texture actually, to save this actually as a PNG. So for example, if you do it like this, you can see the texture in here will be still visible. And I want to save this as a PNG. For me to do that, I'm gonna use the blend if option for this texture in here. So while I'm selecting the dust texture, I will go to this FX icon and choose blending options, and in the blend if I will use this layer, not the underlying layer. I will take this black stop and I will move it a little bit just right like here, and for you to have a smooth like black and gray points, you can just press Alt or Option and split it like this. But for me, I want to keep it harsh and rigid, just like that. I think around 52, and I will press OK. And now we have it saved as a PNG. You can save this, you can even improve it even more, but I think this will add to the print as a texture on top of everything. And for you to actually keep it permanent, you can just create a new layer on top of the texture, the dust texture, and then select the layer and press Ctrl and select the texture, And after that, you can just merge them by press Ctrl or Command E to merge the both layers. And we have it in here set like this. But we need to change the blending mode back to color dodge. And there we go, we have our PNG in here. And then we can just turn on the background. And there we go, we have a really nice design. And the last thing that I want to add actually is some stars in here to give this texture a little bit of shine. So to do that, we're gonna use the shapes, the polygon tool actually. Just make sure that the sides are set to 4. And also in this gear icon, make sure that in here it's set to stars. And in the indent side, I put it to 90% because this is the perfect one for the stars. And the fill, I have it set to white. And then I will just go, for example, I want to add a star in here. I can just go and make my star. You can even rotate it if you want, something like that. And if you press shift, you can add another star within the same file. So let's add another one in here. Alright, I think they are looking really good. And that will be our design. As you can see, it was very easy and quick to do. So I hope that you enjoyed and you like this tutorial and it was a little bit helpful for you. Don't forget to subscribe and comment, and you know, wait for more tutorials to come, and have a nice day. Thank you for watching.